Hello, I am historian Sophia Wyant, and today I will be sharing with you the story of Loretta Janetta Velasquez, a Cuban-born woman who moved to New Orleans at a very young age, married a Texas Army officer, and had a very unusual impact on the Civil War. I will also be sharing with you a video of the challenges she faced throughout her life, and tidbits of information from her early years through and up to the time of her death. So without further ado, lights, camera, action. Hello, I'm Loretta Janetta Velasquez, and today I'll be sharing with you my book, The Woman in Battle, the narrative of exploits, adventures, and travels of Madam Loretta Janetta Velasquez. I will be sharing with you all the things that I did in my early days up until I died. So let's get started with chapter one. Chapter one, early days. I was born in Havana, Cuba on June 26, 1842 to a wealthy family. At the age of seven, I moved to New Orleans to live with my aunt. I went to a boarding school and this is where I learned to speak English. I also enjoyed reading fairy tales and stories of heroism. Joan of Arc, a French war hero, was a big inspiration to me. At the age of 14, my family wanted me to marry a Spanish man named Rafael. However, I decided to marry a Texas United States Army officer named William instead. My family was very upset about my marriage to William. Because of this, we no longer talked. Chapter 2. No is not an answer. My husband resigned from the United States military and joined the Confederate Army in the middle of the Civil War, which was also known as the War Between the States. It was a war between the Northern and the Southern states. The North was called the Union Army, and the South was called the Confederate Army. As for me, I was perfectly well on the subject of war, and although I didn't tell my husband so, I was resolved to forsake him if he raised his sword against the South. I felt that now the great opportunity of my life had arrived, and my mind was busy night and day in planning schemes for making my name famous above that of any of the great heroines of history, not even excepting my favorite, Joan of Arc. In order to accomplish this, I needed to be able to fight in the war. I begged my husband to allow me to join the Confederacy and fight alongside him and the others, but he repeatedly refused my requests. However, I was not going to take no for an answer. So I hatched a plan that would allow me to participate and make a name for myself, even though that name started out as Harry T. Buford. Chapter 3, My Regimen. Undeterred by my husband's refusal, I had a uniform made and disguised myself as a man. I made myself a lieutenant and moved to Arkansas, where, as Lieutenant Harry T. Buford, I raised a regiment of volunteers totaling 236 men in 4 days. I proudly led this group to Pensacola, Florida, where I found my husband and presented them as a regiment under my command. Shortly after we arrived, my husband died while demonstrating the use of weapons to his troops. Guess he wasn't demonstrating very well, was he? Chapter 4, Battleground. After my husband died, I decided to become an independent soldier, and my first experience in combat was the First Battle of Bull Run. I soon became tired of camp life, and I donned female garb, also known as clothing, and went to Washington, D.C., where I became a spy for the Confederacy. I got to meet Abraham Lincoln and the Secretary of War, Simon Cameron. When I returned to the South, I was assigned to the Detective Corps in Tennessee. I fought at Fort Donelson until it was surrendered. Though wounded in battle, I was not exposed and went back to New Orleans. Once there, I was arrested because they thought I was a female Union spy in disguise. When I was released, I enlisted to get away from the city. At the Battle of Shiloh, I found the army I had raised in Arkansas and fought in the battle. When it was over, I was helping to bury the dead when a stray shell wounded me. Once the doctor who examined me found out I was a woman, I again returned to New Orleans, only to see Major General Benjamin Butler take the city. At this point, I gave up my uniform and left for Richmond, Virginia, where I was once again hired to be a spy. This allowed me to travel all around the United States. During my travels, I met and married Captain Thomas D. Klopp. However, he soon died in a Chattanooga hospital, or so I was told. I didn't seem to have much luck with husbands. Heading north, I was then hired to search for, get this, myself. That was fun. I continued to try and fight for the South by attempting to organize a group of Confederate POWs to fight again. But the war was coming to an end as the Confederacy soon surrendered. Chapter 5, Civilian Life. After the war, I married again and moved to Venezuela. But guess what? He didn't make it. Surprise! So I moved back to the U.S. and traveled a lot. I decided to write a book about my life, The Woman in Battle, which I am reading from now. Some people don't believe my story, but I will leave that up to each of you to decide. I was called the woman of business and the woman who can run things like a man. All I ask is that I be judged with impartially as I have only done what I thought to be right. I married again, then moved west to Nevada. Nobody knows when and where I actually died, and I'm still not willing to tell. Thank you.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it and learned a lot. See you next time. Hello, I'm historian Sophia Wyant, and today I will be sharing with you the story of Loretta Jeanette.
Not ready.
Hello. I am married a Texas Army officer at... Nope, I wasn't supposed to say young age.
I was born in Havana, Cuba on June 26, 1842 to a... Hello, I'm Loretta Janetta Vasquez, and today I'll be sharing with you my book.
Stop.